Hi, I'm Rick Uzi, Vice President of Marketing here at Zecorum. We're excited to announce version 3 of PreEqualization Analyzer, our DOCSIS PNM tool. Now, there's a whole lot to tell you about, so keep watching this video to see what's new.
I'm now on the main dashboard, and this looks the same as you're used to. As before, I can go to the Detail view by clicking Total Modems here, or clicking in the menu and selecting Detail view. One of the first differences that you'll see is that the map on the Detail view is now bigger. We don't have the in-channel frequency response chart or the digital taps on the screen where they would normally be over here. We don't have the table below the map. This helps performance and keeps the screen less cluttered. Also, below the map, we've added a legend that tells you what you're looking at. We see our modem severity colors. If a modem has a black line around it, that means that it's a bonded modem. If we select a modem, it will have a blue or dark blue outline around it. If it's in a correlation group, it will be a solid darker color like this. If you have a number in a map pin, that represents stacked modems where you have multiple modems that are very close to each other, and usually it means that they're at the same address. I do see some stacked modems here. I can drill in on those. In fact, a new feature in 3.0 is a satellite view, which is very helpful. When I click that, I can see the homes and the buildings right here. So I'll drill in a little bit further, and I can see that we have what looks like apartments. So these modems are all at the same address. I'll click back to Street View. Another helpful feature is if you have more than one CMTS, there's a checkbox that lets you search across all CMTS. So if you have a MAC address, for example, and you don't know what CMTS it's on, you can enter it right here. Just click Search, and it will search across all CMTS and load the detail screen for that CMTS. In this case, we only have one CMTS, but you can see here we have a selected modem that has the blue outline around it. Another nice feature when you have selected a modem, you can rescan just that modem right here to check its most current readings. Instead of rescanning all the modems, just click this button. If I want to see more details on any of these modems, I can click the flag once. If I want to see even more, I have a couple of options. I can either click More Details, or I'll just X out of that. I can double-click any flag to do the same thing. This is going to open up a window on top of my map. I can move that window or just the size like I normally would by dragging that around. And also down here, I can adjust the size by pulling down on this part of the window. So up here, I have information about the CPE. And since this modem has a bonded upstream, I can see how well the modem is performing on all of those frequencies. In this case, the modem is red on two frequencies and green on one. I can see my in-channel frequency response for each frequency and the digital taps for each, and they're overlaid. I can click the frequency here to see just that frequency in the charts, which is helpful if I want to see those separately. I'll close this window, which will take me back to the map. So the table that you were used to seeing below the map is now under this data tab. So I'll click that, and this should look familiar. Just the usual information up here in this table. Under the signature tab is where I'll find correlation groups and the charts for those. The correlation groups are now indicated by a letter and not a number. I'll pull one up, and you can see that we have a map showing where the correlated modems are located. And we can see the similarity in the in-channel frequency response in this chart right here. I can click the link above the chart, and this will open a window with more information about this correlation. You'll see that I have both charts here, and I've got the table data for the correlation group below that, showing a VTDR of 656 feet in this case for these three modems. By default, all modems are selected in the charts. I can click just on one row and see just the data for that row or multiple rows at a time. I can deselect all modems here, which is going to take me back to the default, which is really all modems selected. Here's another nice feature. I can now rescan just the modems in this correlation group by clicking here. I'll close this window and we can look at some of the reports. There's a new report called a node ranking report. This shows my worst ports and nodes. I can click here to sort to see my worst nodes, for example, my worst channel. Then I can click here to view a map showing only those modems. There's also a new birth certificate feature. In a previous release, we had an install new cable modem feature that was added that would let you do a basic check of a modem's levels to see if there would be an issue with the modem. It just basically told you the modem was good or the modem wasn't good. It didn't give you a lot of information. Now when you do this, it gathers more specific data, and it also generates a birth certificate. So this will give immediate feedback to the installer so they can see where the modem is failing as far as RF stats, micro reflections, group delay, that kind of thing. And then later, when you go to reports and click on search birth certificate for any modems that have been installed using that install CM feature, you can search for modems with a birth certificate, without one, or by MAC address. I'll select with, and I'll see two modems that I put in during testing through that install CM feature. And when I click show birth certificate, it pulls up the state of that modem when I clicked install cable modem. So later, if you have some cable installer install a modem and maybe you need to bring out somebody else to look at it later, they can pull up the birth certificate and we'll get the stats on that modem. There's a new CM list report where you can build a custom report of individual modems to compare their values. I just click right here. I can then start entering MAC addresses. I can type in a few characters and select one when I get a match of the one that I want. I can then look at the readings and the charts for that modem. Then I can click Add to Report, and that moves the data in the table down here to the list. I'll select a few more at random. Here's my next modem. Each time I query a modem, I can click Add to Report to add that modem to the list if I want to. And when I do, you see that the modem has been added to the table at the bottom. I'll select a couple more. Of course, I just did these at random, but I now have several modems in a list that I can compare. By default, I see them all in the charts. If I select one, I see only that modem. I can unselect that and select another one. Or I can select several to look at all of those together. I can delete any from the report by checking this box, clicking Remove MAC, and then confirming Yes. You'll see that that one has now been removed from the list. I can print the report or export it as a CSV file right here. If you're licensed to use the Upstream Analyzer product, which is accessed via the same interface, there are a couple of new features. First, when you have Upstream Analyzer running, you'll now see this yellow bar which shows you where the selected channel is. That could be helpful because the analyzer is going to see other DOCSIS channels that are adjacent to the one that you're looking at. Also, we've added a CPU monitor at the bottom that lets you know the load on the CPU, and specifically, you can see how the load is being impacted from SNMP applications on the CMTS, including Upstream Analyzer or TrueVision. You can see that it's only 2%, so you can be confident that you don't need to worry about load from these tools. There's also a fantastic new feature called Upstream Monitor, which records historical data from the Upstream Analyzer. So, in addition to being able to view the return path spectrum directly from the CMTS at any time, I can now look back in the past. I just click here in the menu on Upstream Monitor, and the first thing I need to do is click the wrench to get to the settings. This is where you would enable polling and turn on monitoring for one or more of your upstreams. In this case, they're all selected, so I'll click Back to Monitor to go back to the monitor screen. Then I need to select one of the upstreams that's being monitored. I'll pick this one right here, and then I need to choose a date range. The calendar is going to show me the period that monitoring data is available, so I'm going to select the whole period for start and end date and click Done. Now here on the right I have a waterfall chart that shows me when a signal or noise is appearing on this channel. I can grab the red line and move back in time, and wherever there was that noise or signal, you'll see red in the chart. In this case, I'm seeing other channels on the chart that the CMTS sees as noise. If I look back further in time here, I see this area in the chart where it looks like something was going on. So let's see if I can get there by pulling the red line to that point. And so you can see that we do have a lot of noise right here that we're looking at. And I'm going to pull this line back up to show you that you can also click this play button to automatically go back in time. And I can speed that up here by clicking or dragging this bar to go to 1, 2, or 3 times as fast as normal.
So that's what's new in version 3. For more resources and videos on DOCSIS PNM, go to PreEqualizationAnalyzer.com.